Hello friends, welcome to Sandip's Biology. In this video, I'll be talking about Vmax and Km and how can we know the value of Vmax and Km for a particular enzyme. So let us start. By this experiment, I will teach you how can we know the Vmax and Km of particular enzyme. So here, 0 to 9, total 10 test tubes are taken, and in these test tubes, the enzyme concentration in all test tubes are same. pH and temperature are also same. What differs here is substrate concentration. So we'll be increasing substrate concentration in each test tubes by 0.05 millimolar. And in the last test tube, substrate concentration reaches to 0.45 millimolar. And when we add substrate into the test tube, enzyme start reacting, enzyme start converting substrate into the product, and at this time we have to measure the velocity, which is known as initial velocity or rate of reaction. We'll be measuring this initial velocity and it is denoted as V or V0, and unit is micromolar per minute. So for all the test tubes at particular substrate concentration, we will measure initial velocity and plot the data, the velocity versus substrate concentration graph. And when we plot the data, we obtain this kind of curve, which is known as hyperbola. All the enzymes following Michaelis-Menten kinetics will give this kind of curve. Several exceptions are there: allosteric enzymes, which do not follow Michaelis-Menten kinetics, will do not give this kind of curve. Rest all of the enzymes will give this kind of curve. So if you see here, in 8 number test tube, measured velocity, initial velocity is 64 micromolar per minute. And in the 9th test tube, the initial velocity is 64 micromolar per minute. So from this point onwards, if you increase the substrate concentration, then the initial velocity remains constant. So if we draw a line from curve to the y-axis, this point, this value around 64, it is known as Vmax. It is the maximum velocity of an enzyme catalyzed reaction. Now if we take half of this Vmax, right, here at this point, one half Vmax, and if we draw a line to the curve and we extend this line to x-axis, then here the point comes, which is known as, this value is known as Km or Michaelis constant. So Michaelis constant is substrate concentration to produce half maximum velocity, right? So this is one half Vmax. So substrate concentration which requires to produce half maximum velocity, it is known as Michaelis constant. Let us see definition of Km. So Km or Michaelis-Menten constant, it is defined as substrate concentration expressed in moles per liter, so molar concentration, to produce half maximum velocity in an enzyme catalyzed reaction, right? So this value indicates that at this substrate concentration, half maximum velocity is produced for enzyme catalyzed reaction, right? What does this value indicate? What does this Km indicate? So small Km value means tight binding between enzyme and substrate, strong affinity between enzyme and substrate. And large Km value, it means weak binding between enzyme and substrate, or we can say that weak affinity between an enzyme and substrate. Here is the Km value of hexokinase for two different substrates are given. Hexokinase, which is working in the brain. For D-glucose, Km value is 0.05 millimolar, and for D-fructose, it is 1.5 millimolar. So small Km value means strong affinity between an enzyme and substrate. So we can say that exokinase shows strong affinity for glucose while weak affinity for D-fructose. So to produce half maximum velocity, glucose concentration required is 0.05 millimolar and for D-fructose 1.5 millimolar fructose D-fructose concentration required to produce half maximum velocity, right? Km value is not dependent on the enzyme concentration. It is independent of the enzyme concentration. It depends on substrate concentration, right? So what if we double the enzyme concentration, does Km value will change? So friends, Km value will not change if we double the enzyme concentration. However, Vmax may change, Vmax may double, but Km value remains the constant. We will see this by taking this example. Here, this red color curve is for one unit enzyme, that is the 100%. And this blue color curve is for two units. We have doubled the enzyme concentration, that is 200%, right? So for 100%, for the one unit enzyme, Vmax is here 100%, and 1/2 Vmax, that is known as Km, it is here, right? So Km, at this point we will get the Km value. And for 200% enzyme, Vmax, we will get the Vmax value here. And if we take half of the Vmax, that is here, 1/2 Vmax, and we will draw the line to the curve and then we'll extend line on x-axis, again we get Km value at this point, right? So this example indicates that if we double the enzyme concentration, Km value remains the same, Vmax is changed, right? So that is all about the Vmax and Km. I hope this video is helpful. If you are watching this video till here, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.